Now, we're taking a look at Newt Gingrich and a name that he keeps mentioning over and over in speeches and interviews. The name is Saul Alinsky. Listen.
The centerpiece of this campaign, I believe, is American exceptionalism versus the radicalism of Saul Alinsky.
I could debate Obama head to head, that I could convey conservative values, and that I could, in an articulate way, explain what American exceptionalism was all about and why the values that he believes in, the Saul Alinsky radicalism that is at the heart of Obama.
I'm going to represent the Declaration of Independence, the Constitution, the Federalist Papers, and the great heroes of American history. He will represent Saul Alinsky, European socialism, secular radicalism, and all the ideas he got at Harvard and Columbia.
Okay, first of all, nothing wrong with getting ideas at Harvard and Columbia, by the way. But also, people listening are like, huh? Who's Saul Alinsky? Well, the speaker mentions Saul Alinsky often, especially when he's talking about President Obama and what Speaker Gingrich believes to be his radical liberal beliefs. So we wanted to ask, who's Saul Alinsky? He's a guy who was born in Chicago in 1909. He was a community organizer, just like young Barack Obama, in Chicago as well. He spent his life helping minorities in poor neighborhoods exert their political force by organizing them to get to the polls. But Alinsky is probably best known for a book that he wrote, which is called Rules for Radicals. And he was referring to Machiavelli's The Prince, and he wrote this. The Prince was written by Machiavelli for the haves to hold power. Rules for Radicals, his book, is written for the have-nots on how to take it away. President Obama has never said that he was influenced by Alinsky. In fact, he was 10 years old when Alinsky passed away. And in doing our research, we found this. Alinsky's organizational tactics haven't only influenced Democrats. In fact, his practices have been linked to some conservatives, and his tactics have been used with great success by the Tea Party. Former House Republican Majority Leader Dick Armey admits he's been influenced by Alinsky, saying, quote, what I think of Alinsky is that he was very good at what he did, but what he did was not good. And in an interview with the Financial Times, the head of FreedomWorks, which is aligned with the Tea Party, said regarding Alinsky's work, we don't organize people to turn up at these town hall meetings, but we tell them about the meetings and we suggest good questions they could ask. Sounds like something Alinsky might do. The problem, perhaps, that Newt Gingrich has with Alinsky and the reason he's trying to link him to President Obama wasn't really Alinsky's organizational skills, but the book outlining how the have-nots could take power from the haves. So we will be sure to ask the former speaker that next time we get a chance to talk to him.